It is June 7th. I'm a little bit behind on my deer chores. That's what I'm doing today, at least for a little while. I gotta go to work later. But I'm out here putting on batteries and cameras, moving them around, refreshing the mineral sites. I guess one behind me I'm getting ready to touch up. This will be the second dose of mineral for the year. Like I said, I'm running behind, but it's time to get back after them, I guess. Had to watch turkey season fade into the rear view, unfortunately, but happens every year and we gotta roll with it, try and survive the summer and the fall and the winter and get right back after them next spring. But for now, my focus has shifted back over to deer, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get these cameras all freshened up, get some new batteries in them, and then go ahead and start pouring the old Rack Fuel Cherry Vanilla. I got 3 bags of this stuff I want to get out today. 3 more at home that may go out later or at a different farm. I'm not real sure yet. But yeah, we're going to get her done. It's time to put the summer prep work back into action and see if we can't find us a deer to chase this fall. All right, what's up, y'all? It is August 31st. Back down here on the big farm. Getting ready to work on a food plot here behind me. It's kind of overgrown with some weeds, but I came down here earlier this year, hit it with some clover, so that's why it looks as green as it does. There's still a lot of clover out in it from what the deer haven't used, but I got my rake with me today. I came down last weekend, I think, and hit it with some clethodim, tried to kill off some of the grass that's in it, or at least start the process of killing it. Some of it hasn't died yet, so we're gonna get this plot raked up. I got some corn for the feeder over my shoulder a little ways behind me, and then we're gonna get some seed on it. I've got 1 can from last year of the Rack Fuel Rack Reaper, and then this year I picked up Rack Fuel Checkmate. It's like I think both of them are like a brassica blend, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, turnips, cabbage, turnips, rapeseed, kale, brassicas. So it's done me pretty good down here the last couple of years. I've had a lot of deer using it ever since I started putting this spot in. So we're gonna keep doing it. But for now, I'm gonna hurry up and get this plot raked up and get that feeder topped off. All right, check the camera over there. I gotta put new batteries in that camera over there, so okay, I'm watching the feeder. And we get all this work done, hurry up and get out of here for the day. All right, is this thing on? Yeah, it's on. What's up, y'all? It is September 28th, 2024, opening day of deer season here in Ohio. Just left the house there a little bit ago. It's about 20 to 3. I'm headed back down to the big farm where I do all my deer hunting. Gonna mix things up a little bit for now. Normally I hunt with a compound bow. Turnaround this year, sold my original bow, bought a new bow, and we bought a house and everything else, and it's not in the budget right now to set the new bow up. So I'm hunting with my crossbow for now. If I can get the new bow set up before I kill a buck, then I will start hunting with the new bow. But for now, I'm hunting with a crossbow. I've been feeding these bucks because we're allowed to do that here in Ohio. So just a little disclaimer, if you don't like that, if you don't like crossbows, you don't like guys hunting over corn pile, that's fine. I'm not gonna sit here and try and win you over. You can click off the video and go on about your day. If you don't mind all that, then stick around, because I'm headed to the blind right now. Got all my gear in the back, got the four-wheeler, got all my clothes aired out, and we're gonna go see if we can't stick us a good one tonight. We got a couple different bucks coming into this spot. Actually, they both came in yesterday evening right at dark according to the camera. A big, what I assume to be 5 years old, given the history that I've got with the deer, a big five-year-old that I call Weird Al. He's a big 9-point. The name's got a little back history to it because he used to be a weird buck and he grew out of it, but the name just kind of stuck. And then another buck that he's running with is a deer that I call Drifter. I started noticing him last year for obvious reasons. He got the name Drifter because he likes to roam around. He's not as patternable as Weird Al. Weird Al's a homebody. But for now, we're gonna go crawl in the blind. I think if either buck walks out tonight, I'll probably try and run an arrow through one. If Weird Al steps out into the field, he'll be my main target. But if Drifter is by himself this evening, then I am probably not gonna be too shy of taking a shot at him if we can get him in range. But yeah, that's all there is to it. We're headed to the blind. It's raining right now. It's been raining about all day. We just come out of a nasty drought. Two and a half months of basically no rain. So the food plot's not doing too well right now. It's doing, but it's not doing well. Bucks are still on their feet moving around in daylight. So I'm hoping this rain pushes out here within the hour and I can get in dry. According to the radar, there was a slightly elevated risk of rain right before dark. So hopefully, I'm being optimistic here, opening day, I'm being optimistic about getting these bucks up and moving on their feet before dark this evening, with that rain supposedly coming in right before dark. So if that's the case, we may get a shot at one. If not, then I guess we'll start dragging this tag out like I did last year. I dragged it all the way to gun season last year. Not because I wanted to either, but I'm gonna shut up, get on down the road here, and we're gonna get on down to the farm, get dressed, and go crawl in a ground blind. Deer season 2024, here we go. All right, here we go, I'm going in. Just left the truck up there at the barn. Got down here on the edge of these, woods on this big wooded draw. I'll show you. My plan is, about like I do every year, I'm gonna get right along the edge of these woods, and once it opens up a little bit farther down, I'm gonna drop down into this draw. That way nothing on the other side of the hill can see me come down, and I'll be able to slide right up into the back of this blind, hopefully without spooking anything. So I'm gonna sneak down through here. All these leaves are still pretty wet, so it's pretty quiet. And crawl into the back of this blind. Hopefully we'll get a shot at one of these bucks tonight. The rain just stopped, so hopefully they'll get up on their feet and move before dark. Fingers crossed, here we go. Does it actually work out how we want it to, but I'm optimistic.
smoked him. Pretty sure I smoked him. He's going down. He's going down in the field. In the field. Booyah. He's not done. Yes, booyah, baby. Boom. Sorry, guys, I'm still getting over a cold. Thank you, Lord. Thought I heard another deer behind me. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord. Yes! Let him walk a bunch. There's a tree right here I used to have a stand in. I ended up killing Phantom out of. Let that deer walk a bunch that year, 2022. Had an elevated platform and a big gnarly sycamore right here to my right. Let that deer walk a bunch out of there. I used to hunt over there on that food plot last year. Let him walk a bunch over there. And then finally, he got a little bit of size to him, and I thought, that's gonna be my target. That's gonna be my target buck for the year. I'm pretty sure that deer's 5 years old. And I just had a. What in the world? He's trying to get back up. Ain't no way in the world. I just double lunged him. But anyway, I've had a lot of history with that deer, and he just walked right in here and got smoked. Opening evening, 2024. I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I'd love to have got him with my new bow. It's not set up right now, but I'll take that any day of the week, crossbow or otherwise, I don't care. That was awesome, that buck. I watched him come off the bank here. I turned around just to look, and there's an old tractor road that runs down the hill behind me and comes out into this field. And I just happened to catch movement, and I kind of peeked. I peeked through this little gap, and he was standing over there nibbling. And he, for whatever reason, did not want to come in. And then finally he decided he was comfortable when he'd come on down. I didn't even see the doe with him until after he'd have got out there. He made a big loop around the feeder. Come in, faced me forever. I hate it when they do that. Now I'm getting the jitters. I hate it when they do that. They come in, they face you, and they don't give you a shot. And finally, I got him to turn just enough, slightly quartering too. I really didn't want to shoot him hard quartering. I had to let him wait, and I had to wait and let him turn broadside, or as broadside as I could stand to let him get, because I was getting all kinds of shook up watching that deer. He's still expiring over there on the edge of the field, but I don't think he's going anywhere. He just took a G5 dead meat straight through the ribs. I don't know that he's gonna get back up after that one. Yeah, baby, opening day 2024. Oh, thank you, Lord, thank you. All right, I'm gonna make some phone calls. Man, I love crawling out of the blind, walking out in the field when it's still daylight. I don't know if you can see the blind right there. It is I'm gonna walk up here to a completely blood-soaked arrow. Look at that. There's the blind. No, big boy is down. Right over there.
I'll come back pick up a Sarah here in just a minute. Let's walk over here and get our hands on him. Thank you, Lord. Weird Al is down. 3 years worth of history with this deer. Big old 9-point. Well, my GoPro keeps on acting up. I don't know why, so I'm gonna use the big camera. This deer is quite the specimen. Just a big old 9-point. Tickle his ear there for a minute, make sure he's expired. I figure he is. Look at this guy. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at that. Yeah. Yes, sir. Soaking wet horns. Been raining on him about all day. Whoa. Sorry about that. It's been raining on him about all day. I figured he'd get up a little bit early tonight and walk around. And that was the wrong play, my guy. So I'm gonna set some of my gear up here, try and get some pictures real quick before it gets too dark. And we're gonna get him out of here. Well, all right, y'all, there he is. That's the deer we call Weird Al. I can get in a little bit more on the backstory of why we call him Weird Al. 2022, I had this deer down here, and I wanna say it was this side. I'm not entirely sure though. It had a weird, long, sweeping main beam with like one wee little tiny G2 and an awkward looking brow tine, and then this side was normal. And he looked kinda weird, hence the name Weird Al. Never thought a whole lot of him that year just because he was young and little, and I thought he was 3 years old. And then last year had him down here, kind of anticipated on him being abnormal again, and he wasn't. He just wasn't extremely big as what I presume to be a 4-year-old, 8-point, not super tall tines, decent beams, decent spread. Elected to give him the pass quite a few times last year. Told Dad, if Dad wanted him, he could get on him and try and kill him, and Dad never got on him. Ended up making it through the season. Found one of his sheds, actually just up on the hill here behind me in a clover patch. And then coming into this season, he was kind of in the back of my mind. There were some other bucks in the area that I knew of, and I wanted to kind of get a general idea what bucks were still around, what bucks were bigger, what bucks were gonna make the hit list this year. And lo and behold, this old boy was the first one to show up in the summertime. I had some velvet pictures of him. Didn't see him a whole lot through the summer. Once I started feeding over here outside this cow pasture, he was coming in quite a bit, making some good growth. Come out of velvet, coming into early September, and I knew he was probably going to be number one on the list. If I could get on him early, I was gonna try. And as you guys saw, that's exactly what happened. I opted not to hunt this morning because he's been coming in about 5 a.m. every day. This morning he come in at 1:30, and then again at 3:30, and then he didn't come back in at all. And I thought, it's gonna rain all day. He's probably gonna lay up there on the hill, stay in his bed, and with any luck, he's gonna get up and move a little bit earlier this evening. And that's exactly what he did. I think I got eyes on him at about 6:30 or 6:40-ish, or about 6:30, I think. Came in not exactly the way I wanted him to. He come in and faced me for way too long. Got all anxious. Knew I had to be patient, wait on a good shot. And finally, he decided to spin around there on the corn pile, give me just a slightly quartering two shot. The exit, you can see, is just a touch back, but the entrance was good.
And the rest is history. You guys saw it. He ran over here and stumbled around for a while and eventually expired. So I guess that ends the story of Weird Al and my buck hunt for 2024.